The Gardner name is synonymous with the Chelsea Football Club, and Todd Gardner this week plays his 100th game for the Seagulls. Well, Todd, congratulations on the milestone. What's it mean to you?
Yeah, thanks, mate. Yeah, it means a great deal. Obviously, I've grown up here since under-9s right through, so it's been a good journey, and yeah, it's come pretty quick.
You played most of your football here. You had 2 years at Frankston, one senior game there under Simon Goosey. What did you learn about football? What did you learn about yourself and getting an opportunity at VFL level, even though it was so brief, unfortunately?
Yeah, it's a lot different to local footy, the way they, I guess, dissect games and the transition and ball movement and all that type of thing. I was able to bring back a fair bit from there to back to Chelsea, and yeah, feel like it's made me grow as a footballer. So that was a good experience, although it was only 2 years. It was good.
No regrets that you didn't play more? Would have you liked another crack at it?
Yeah, there are some. I had two hip ops, so my body wasn't really holding up too well, but yeah, there is a little bit of regret. I would have liked to have given it a little bit longer, and you know, hopefully maybe have got a crack at seniors a bit more, but yeah, I'm happy now.
How different was the pace? Now, I suppose you don't get much time to get rid of the footy compared to the standard of footy here, even though it's an excellent standard.
Yeah, that was the thing I found the most challenging, was the time with the footy, and also just the ball movement. There's a lot of switching and all that, where local footy it's more, you know, kick down the line and that type of thing. So yeah, that's the biggest thing I noticed, was the pace, the different type of pace.
Seagulls are in a good position. It was a brutal game last week. 9 goals, 4, you kicked accurately, but certainly helped. And Kringle kicked 7-13. Just about your best win for the year?
Yeah, it was a gut-wrenching win. I think the third quarter we had the wind, and we really didn't do enough with it. But to Kringle's credit, they kind of shut the game down for that quarter and made it hard for us to score. So three-quarter time, we're definitely probably the underdogs to win. And I think we kicked a goal, Reedy kicked a goal last two minutes of the game, and we were able to hold on and force stoppage after stoppage at the end there. And yeah, it was probably the biggest win for us for the year.
Does that give you the belief you can win it now?
It certainly does. I think there's a sense of belief in this group as we win more games, but you know, that's a long way away, and there's a lot of water to go under the bridge yet. But we'll just keep going week by week, and new challenges each week arrives.
Because the premiership's important, but no doubt the caveat of going back to first division and play against the best is also the other aspect that's different about the competition now. I mean, how good's that?
Yeah, the premiership, that's the dream. So we'll keep striving for that. And yeah, as you said, the two divisions now has enabled clubs like us to rebuild and grow, and you know, to create a winning culture. And so to go up there again and have another crack at those teams would be good, and I reckon we'd be, you know, in a better position second time around.
Will the league be even in a better position if they had a third division?
Oh, I'm not sure. I've heard a little bit of rumours about all that. I kind of just stay clear of all that. I like how it is now. I'm not sure about a third division, but I'm not in charge of that. So I'll just keep trying to get a kick, I guess.
Because the issue again is that there are so many neighbouring football clubs around here, and some are not even in the Mornington Peninsula Football League. There are a couple, of course, that are in the Southern Football League. You would have thought it makes sense for you all to be in the same league.
Yeah, I guess, but I think we've, this new year league now, we travel down the peninsula, and it's not that far of a drive really, and there's no traffic, so I don't really think location is that big of a difference in terms of who you play, but yeah, we'll see what happens.
And James is your coach, he's a playing coach. What's it like having him as a playing coach? What does he bring to the table? It's a bit different to previous coaches.
Yeah, he's been really good. Obviously, first year as coach, and as a playing coach, it's probably even more difficult, but he's come into the role and he's lived up to all expectations. His form has probably been the best in the 3 years he's been here, has been the best this year. And pretty much what he says, he leads out in the field. And he finds that balance of being your mate, but being your coach also. So no, the boys definitely respect him, and yeah, we love what he's doing.
Your dad coaches the reserves. Does he give you much advice, Steve?
Yeah, every now and then. I'll just tell him to stick to 12 o'clock, but each break he might come up to me and give me a little word here and there, but yeah, no, he's been a role model for me, so he's been good.
Good on you, Todd. It's fantastic to play 100 games. You've done a great job. Your team's flying this season. Good luck on the 100th. Good luck for the rest of the year. And thanks for joining us on Game Face.
Thanks, mate. Appreciate it.
Good on you.